Ritu Rebels. Species, Ritu. Planet, Retalia. Unnamed planet, P6J813. Status, friendly. Central Authority of Ritu, in exile. Hostile, Rebels. Compiled by Captain Rodriguez. A lot has happened since the Ritu attacked SGC. The Central Authority of Ritu is currently a government in exile, and the Rebels have become the dominant Ritu faction. The Rebels' goal remains to destroy all potential Goa'uld hosts. That means Unas, Jaffa, Tok'ra, the mythical Sekhmet, and above all, the Tari. They've not launched a second attack on Earth yet. Perhaps they believe transphase eradication rods be more ubiquitous on Earth than they are. Or they decide to cut down on our allies before coming at us directly. The Sumerians have reported encounters with the Ritu. Fortunately, the protections left by the Asgard easily repelled them. But I worry about the Ritu going after more vulnerable allies, such as the Argosians or Madronans. At my request, Spravel asked the Tolan to look into improving the range and portability of transphase eradication rods. They contested, but have no results to show us yet. The Ritu rebels recently attacked the Goa'uld Kali, who subsequently forced/bribed/blackmailed SG-1 into repelling the threat for her. Reading Major Carr's report, this alliance was far from pleasant, but it does offer options. Apparently, the Goa'uld hate the Ritu more than they hate us. And from an immediately practical point of view, an enemy who wants to keep you as cattle is better than one who wants you exterminated. If we pursue this avenue, however, in addition to all usual precautions in working with the Goa'uld, we should take care to protect the Central Authority. The RCA remains an ally of the Tari and reached out after a rebel attack on my team. They are horrified by the plans of their rebel brethren to eradicate all potential hosts and are willing to put their lives on the line to stop them. Unfortunately, their numbers are low and they've been forced into exile. In fact, they've been forced off their homeworld entirely. I should note that despite the name Ritu Central Authority, they count both members of the government in exile and families comprised of Ritu citizens. The Ritu Civil War puts us in an awkward position. The US government prefers to stay out of internal affairs of other nations, though in this case, one side wants us dead and the other does not. The Phoenix Alliance has the same problem, though more based in practicality than morals. Interference risks alerting the rebels to our position, and given the species in the coalition, we'd likely become a prime target. Nor can we simply fold the RCA into the alliance, as the Jaffa and Tok'ra can't function around them. The Ritu's history with the Goa'uld, however, makes them eligible for aid from the Home Initiative. It's a very tangled web, which I believe warrants a diplomatic mission to the RCA to explore options. The address to their new location, which I refuse to put down in writing to protect their safety, is known to both General Hammond and Lawyer. I made inquiries about the child Charlie. We haven't heard from him since the Tok'ra took him to cure the faults in his genetic makeup. This lack of information was not an issue before, since the Ritu rebels had ceased their attack on Earth, and the Tok'ra value their privacy. Given current developments, however, I asked Orion to make inquiries. Apparently, Charlie is still alive and successfully blended, but different from the other Tok'ra. Perhaps this stems from his ability to see Ritu? Regardless, I asked for a meeting with Charlie, which Orion declined. I have since requested General Lawyer to ask for a meeting. The Tok'ra do like hierarchy, and I hope they might reconsider if it came from him. So far, the General has opted not to press the issue with the Tok'ra. I am also aware of the option of having Colonel O'Neill ask, as I suspect the Tok'ra will agree given his relationship with the child. However, I am loath to play on personal sympathies, nor do I want to put the Colonel on the spot. If you don't want to put someone on the spot, don't put it in your report. O'Neill!